Greetings and welcome to another episode of Knights of Azure. Off camera, I had done a little bit more training stuff, and I think today is going to be lots of events because I saw a lot of people out on the field with events over their heads. But first, let's drop in these sandals. Oh, I have a few. I kind of don't want to drop them off now. Thank you for the sandals. They were perfect. Because I actually want to do some tests with these sandals. And expect any less from my knight. Who is sending these? Alright, I'm going to test these sandals. I like the blood spear with the... for being able to, add time, but... add SP, but, I'm thinking... oh wait, which one of these do I... alright, where's the sandals? I should probably put this on too, but for now, let's just try out the gladiator sandals. I want to see what... adds 5 seconds to chain after the first attack. I want to see what that means. And you know what, let's just do this thing. Maybe I'll get more fetishes from enemies or something. Where's the coin? Do I really have this many items? Oh boy. Coin, I gotta sell some stuff, there it is. Alright. Let's go. We're gonna watch all these events. Don't worry about me, Arnest. To have you protecting me is reassuring enough. Aw, thank you. Singing Wolf, Creeping Forest, and the Spider Bride. These fuel the rumors of the Black Butterfly outbreak. To solve this mystery, will you have a duel with me? What the hell? I came out of nowhere. What a pain. Seriously, what a pain. You don't have to say it's a pain twice. We're dueling to locate and hunt these mysterious fiends. If you win, I'll never follow you around again. Deal. You have accepted Professor Alucard's fiend hunting duel. You answer pretty fast. Oh well, but if I win, you have to become my assistant. Understood? Yeah, sure, whatever. Yeah, because you're like I'm gonna lose. I put multiple locks on my door, but if I'm staying in a hotel with an expert thief, there's not much else I can do. If I had known this was going to happen, I would have borrowed Luis's safe. There's nothing I can do about what has happened. Let's shake him down together, Arnest. Oh, what if it's in the safe? What's wrong, little lady? You look troubled about something. Well, whenever I go shopping, I notice all that the merchants' wares never change. This is a small island. They can only reliably sell whatever they manage to import. But do they need to get all their stuff from the same place? What about goods from other countries further away? Far away countries, huh? I guess I can ask him. Him? This trade merchant I know. He travels the world. Sometimes I ask him to pick stuff up for me. He always finds rather interesting goods. A trade merchant, huh? Will he really sell to me? He's not like most merchants, though. I can't guarantee what he'll bring. I don't need to worry about that, do I? Maybe. Oh, trade merchant. Cool. I don't trust that guy. How do we know the Black Book was the real deal to begin with? Keep an eye on that book word. He'll show his true colors soon enough. Alright, what's in the trade merchant? Oh, jeez. Do I actually get to select something? Alright, there's a lot of question marks here. Oh, and this costs a lot of Libra to do. So for once, I can justify the cost of having this much Libra. But here's the deal. What happens if I send him out and this stuff is junk? I was gonna do a cheap one. Alright, I gonna buy this cowbell. Just because I'm really curious. Nothing else is really new here. Alright. So let's go see if those other events are still where I found them. I don't know if there's gonna be like, oh geez, there's a thing right there. Alright, I think this is where I found, where I started to find the first ones. Maybe? I think so. So let's just see if we can find those events. Yeah, I believe this is where I started out. Hello! Oh, I should check for quests too, screw it. I just gotta go. Oh, hello. The spider bride is a fiend that lures men to their deaths. I wonder what else it is capable of. Tracking this place down is exactly what I expect from you, Arnis. Professor, let's see who finds the spider bride first. Duel on, Arnis. See you later. Got it. I hope we'll wait. First dream. Okay. So whatever this is has nothing to do with, yeah. This has nothing to do with the scenario. Good. Good, good. It has nothing to do with the main chapters. Because I don't want to jump chapters too soon if there's more stuff to do. In case I lose the potential to do that stuff in later chapters. I mean, sometimes you don't. So, I mean, I would think you wouldn't. I would think you'd be able to, you know, do it whenever. But I just want to be sure. You know, that's just how I am. I like being. Well, I'm gonna have to go back though. I'm gonna have to go back to the dream to level up. But hopefully, it'll just be like a cutscene thing, and then oh, geez. And there's that other event right over there, too. According to my research, this should be the place. It does look suspicious. Arnis, whoa! Professor! I have no choice but to defeat it. Yes, let's kill this thing. Was that it? I think that was it. You found the spider bride. You have won the fiend hunt this time. Oh, Arnis, you killed it for me. Most impressive. Professor, you don't mind, right? Just what is the spider anyway? I suppose I'll ask it myself. I'll just ask it myself. Is that supposed to be fiend tongue? I think you'll understand the gist of it. I was just an ordinary spider. She understood him. I had a web on the edge of a teller's roof. He worked so hard. I wish I could make beautiful fabric like him. We spiders love people. We like to watch them scurry about. Hopefully I can spin a web at my next house. I'm not even gonna bother translating that. Hold on a second. After discussing it, I have agreed to look after her, so don't worry. Oh, and you have won this duel, Arnis. Goodbye. The fiend tongue actually worked. So he knows something. He knows something. So is he on our side or against us? Oh, man. I mean, first impressions say he's on our side, but who's to say? What do you guys think? What do you guys and gals think? Which one of these are the imposter? Which one is the one actually trying to help us? Is it the professor or the merchant? Observing fiends, obviously. Skitterfoot type fiends were originally created, such as spiders, paws. juicy crabs, succulent lobsters, so they're mostly crustaceans. No, I just want to eat seafood. Go back to the hotel and get something to eat. Ernest, now's your chance. Give me some chocolate and I will do anything you want. And I do mean anything. Ew, no. Then I'm going home. I guess I blew through my food budget. Maybe I'll beg my donor for more money. Who funds his research anyway? That was weird and random. I guess I could have talked to him before, but I didn't want it to be off camera. But yeah, hopefully me going to the dream will just initiate a cutscene and then they will tell me to go somewhere else. Because I really don't want to have to withhold leveling up. I mean, I don't even know if I'm going to have enough money to level up. I've been spending blood. Alright, I saw another event in the amusement park. I think it was with the merchant. So, let's see. Ooh, more blood! Switch weapons! And learn how to hit with them. Oh yeah, that's right. I was supposed to be paying attention to my equipment thing. Looks like it's definitely helping me to keep my chain up. Yeah, it's definitely going a lot slower. My main question when it comes to chain, though, will that help me build up the demon form meter faster? I lost it. I wasn't close enough, I guess. Alright, let's go to the event. More bombardiers. Oh, my bomb died. Go, get out of there! That was close. Looks like my fourth person died. I don't remember who that is off the top of my head. Oh, it was the red thing. Oh no, it's actually the professor again. What are you doing? Observing fiends, obviously. They're toy soldier fiends, but it's unclear if they're human soldiers or toys that were turned into fiends. I think they used to be toys. I think they used to be humans. If they were former humans, I think they'd have more human features. That's clearly a toy. Oh, sweet naive Ernest. There are reports of a soldier who was exposed to fiend blood and assumed that form when he was transformed. Is that true? I think blue blood reacts to a person's innate qualities. It provides a form that the person desires most. Whenever war breaks out, massive armies of soldiers appear. Where do you think the men of those armies come from? Men who are manipulated, trampled upon, and abandoned, that form is forced upon them. They didn't become toy soldiers because of the blue blood, it's because humans enslave other humans. So that's what you think. While still being researched, we may know more about toy soldier fiends in the future. Please excuse me. Well, it's also possible that they're toy soldiers because, what? I have to break these again? Yeah, that's right. You go, Ace. You're my ace. Let's get these guys back up on the field. Okay, so this is pretty much all I know of. There might be more events in the other two areas, so I'm not gonna return right away because I kind of want to get more blood. So so I'm gonna just skip ahead here, and I will see you back on the map, and we will check out the we will check out the other locations and see if we can find any more professor events like these. Because they're kind of interesting. Oh, there's another event right there. I wasn't expecting there to be another event. Actually, this one may be the merchants that I thought was here. Oh boy, I'm stunned. Thankfully, I did not get hurt. Man, my bomb guy likes to die a lot. Of course, you know, exploding probably costs him a lot of power. Alright, nope, it's a professor again. I guess there's just always a professor. I saw the merchants at one point, but I guess it's just always the professor, which makes sense. I guess the merchant would only go out if it pertained to collecting treasure. He has no reason to really be out. Even more reason to be suspicious of the merchant. This spot right here is slightly crystallized. This doesn't appear to be the work of humans. What are you doing? Investigating buildings that have turned into fiends. Where I'm from, there is a building known as the Lost House. Inside are cups of hot tea and bowls of hot soup. But there's not a soul to be found. It's very eerie. But if you take one of those cups or bowls, it's said to bring you good luck. Are you sure you didn't just wander to strangers' house and steal their stuff? That's a good one, Arnis. But if people lived in the Lost House, that would make me a thief. Oh. At any rate, researching fiend buildings is boring, and there isn't much for me to work with. Good day. Oh, boy. I really do not know what to make of this professor guy. Okay, now I'm pretty sure that's all of the events. So I will see you guys on the world map. Oh my god. There is yet another event. Alright, let's go see this new event. Here's the merchant. I knew I saw the merchant somewhere. One ring bearing a coat of arms, one still life drawing, and one patterned shawl. That should do it. Another get-rich-quick scheme. Playing a treasure hunt? Are you fiend-hunting, little lady? Need anything? What? We're gonna go shopping? Okay. Oh, it's just the market. In fact, it's the same market. Nothing has changed. Still don't feel like I need these. Alright. Anyway. That was kind of bleh. Anyway, now, again, officially, I will go see you on the world map. See you soon. Oh. Okay, so we're back. I finally got through all that. And the professor here is another event. Professor, about that spider. It's no problem. Don't worry about it. Okay. That was abrupt. Oh, hey. Are you the spider? Here you are. This place is quite comfortable and accepts fiends along with humans. It reminds me of my hometown. Where did you used to live? Well, I can't quite remember, and I've never left this island, but I remember a place that was different from this one. Humans and demons. No, it was more like half-demons and fiends. They lived together in a city of artists. Anyway, I'm glad you knocked some sense into me. Because of that, I can weave my web in this amazing place. You have my thanks. No problem. Okay, cool. Oh, and an event with one of the new guys.
This hotel is relaxing. I can sleep comfortably on the sofa and bed.
That's not true, meow. I still haven't gone to the suite, meow. so adorable. Alright, let's get back out into the map. Oh, there's a exclamation point here. Actually, anyway, I'm just gonna do a quick search for new events. So, see you when I find something. Alright, here's one of the events. It's rather early in the stage. Oh, hello! I don't have the black one. What are you doing? Observing fiends, obviously. Demons are incarnations of nature, and fae represent that in its purest form, as incarnations of specific elements. Each earth fae are excited, they cause earthquakes. When water fae are excited, they cause rainstorms. By studying their movements, we can determine whether they'll bring fortune or misery. I'm surprised that you do research that benefits other people, Professor. Well, I'm just sucking up to my donors. Research without results means less research funding for me. But there sure are a lot of fae. Yeah, every one you find, three more show up out of nowhere. I see, your perspective as a seasoned agent is rather unique. You're saying that groups of fae are like cockroaches. I don't think they agree. Oh my, they left. I should probably go as well. See you later. I don't think the fact that they liked what you just said. Alright. Anyway, that was that event. So, I'm gonna go try and find more. Be back again. Oh, hello. It is said that once you set foot in the creeping forest, you will never find the way out. I expected you to find this place, Arnis. Professor, let's duel to see who finds the creeping forest first. Arnis? Very well. And then there's also a other event. So let's just do the demon research event since we're right here. What are you doing? So sleepy. What am I supposed to do about that? Oh, it's you, Arnis. Sorry. I don't think this hot room gives off a strange... Don't you think this hot room gives off a strange aura? I don't know if it's the heat or the humidity, but my head is starting to feel a little woozy. You know how objects exposed to the blood develop a will of their own and turn into fiends? Places that have been exposed to blue blood probably developed wills and underwent transformations too. Locations that have become fiends. I think I get it. Maybe we're getting closer to the never-ending night. Gah. Don't sleep with your eyes open. What a terrible feeling this is. I need a powerful fiend account or I won't last much longer. I'll turn in for the evening. He's going home in that state? Well, when you gotta go, you gotta go. I mean, if you don't want to stay when you're clearly in a bad spot. Alright, now let's go find this other quest thing. Alright, here we go. What is that? at an event. Talk to you? Are they asleep? Some of them look like they have their heads in the cloud. Huh? This is... Whoa! What are they summoning? A big version of themselves, clearly. Too easy. Alright, where's the professor? There. You have found the creeping forest. You have won the fiend hunt this time. I wonder. I expected nothing less from you, Arnes. Professor, the blue blood that fell around the world changed whole hearts and bodies with just one drop. Those that could not tolerate the change became fiends, but some of them did not completely lose their hearts. I wonder what would happen if blood or other bodily fluids were put in fiends that still have their hearts. Blood? Now go on, drink. This is what you desire. This is what you lost. Whoa. So pretty. How beautiful. I've gone through so many concoctions. So this is the sap. These are cherry blossom trees. Cherry blossoms? The most cherished flower in my homeland. Oh, this is acceptable. You have won our wager, Arnes. What he said about putting blood into fiends that still have their hearts, why is that bothering me? I don't know. Kind of bothers me too. He knows a lot about fiends, clearly. Anyway, there may be another professor event somewhere in this particular map, considering the track record. So I will see you once I find that, or back at the hotel. See you soon. Alright, we're back again. Let's see what the professor has to say this time. Professor, what about that incident from before? You made the cherry blossom fiends. I'm glad you helped. Thanks to you, I was able to put them to rest. If I had more data, I could revert fiends back to their original form. So that's the kind of research you do? What did you think I do? People obsess over demons. Just because I like demons doesn't mean I throw my life away for them. Alright, that's done. Oh, actually, I completely forgot to look at quests last time. Oh, Mandrake Leaves and Toy Soldier? Let's check it out. Done. Nutcracker. Okay. Well, let's go back out, I guess. Still seems kind of a waste to me, but... Oh, hello! Master, aren't you cold? If you ever are, I can warm you up! Oh, that's so adorable. Alright, let's just check the central square real quick. See if I can find any more events from the professor. And if not, well, then I guess... Oh, yeah, there's one right there. Oh, wait, no, that's the merchant. Oh, no, it's both of them. The bitterness and acidity blend together to form a complex depth of flavor. Black coffee is the best. The refreshing aroma of the creamy milk that adds 5 sugar cubes. Milk tea is the best. I'm sure I already know the answer, but what are you doing? Nice of you to join us, little lady. Simon decided to replenish his stock of luxury goods to meet the demands of his guests. So today, we coffee lovers will finally defeat the sweet tea sippers and claim the drink menu for ourselves. We tea lovers will purge this cafe of bitter coffee apologists and claim this cafe for ourselves. Oh yeah, this is about the drink budget. So how are you two going to decide the winner and loser? With a taste test, obviously. Go on, drink my black coffee. Go on, drink my milk tea. No. What do you mean, no? Yes, explain yourself. We've been waiting to serve you delicious tea and sludge water. How can you say you won't drink any? Don't call it sludge water. Only adults can appreciate coffee's tongue-tingling flavor. Besides, this battle won't end until you drink the coffee and melt it. Come on, work with us here. This is all not melted. You can't understand the soft sweetness that touches your heart. More like sucks out your soul. You only think sugar cubes are good for is a drunken dance. What? Is this tongue-numbing sensation some kind of torture? What kind of sadistic game are you playing? Well, your coffee is too bitter. Professor, your tea is too sweet. Why not just mix them together? Like this. You idiot, stop. Ernest, watch out. Huh? What's going on? There. This pointless fight is over. But as long as coffee lovers and tea lovers exist, this battle will never end. Until the day that drinks on the hotel menu stand united, there will be no rest for these warriors. That was what we get for underestimating the chocolate-loving assassin. Let's make Simon taste them instead. Yes, let's take a break for now and come up with a battle plan. Simon, I believe in you. Okay, that was worth it. Alright, I'm off to search for more events. Like one right here. What are you doing? Obviously, fiends. Obviously, observing fiends. Obviously, they are concept fiends. Negative emotions such as hate, sorrow, jealousy, and suspicion that manifest in a physical form and become fiends. What does that do to the original human? Purging all the negative activity is probably like an extreme form of detox. I imagine it's quite therapeutic. I see. There are some guys who might just vanish into thin air if they had that happen to them, like Lloyd. That Lloyd, his soul is consumed by greed. If I'm experiencing a similar purge, I'm confident I remain unchanged, for I live a life of honest poverty. No way, then you stop asking me to stop being your assistant. Me? But I'm so devoted to my research. I would never. When did I become so corrupt? Yeah. Alright. Not much to say on that one. Oh my god, what's going on now? Kitties! What is that? I must give it my best shot. I can do this. Okay? Madame, though your face and body is bigger than ours, your fluency is most impressive. Meow, Mr. Sage, I will work hard and do my best to attend all the meowtings. Thank you very meowch. What the? What is that creature? What is she meowing about? Stay calm. Just stay calm. Phew. All right. That was so adorable. Oh, what's that? Event and some more questing. I'm just gonna ignore everything at this point. Oh, another shop in this area. Sorry, I'm short on goods. The shipments I was waiting for never made it to me. Talk about your bad luck, huh? I wonder if something happened. Well, the Knight's Awakening is near. It wouldn't surprise me if the Deliverer decided to entail free. Still, the world's riches flow through the station, so we can never short on help for other countries. After all, this is the front line of the battlefield for humanity's future. I don't know how I feel about people taking credit for fighting when all they did was deliver money and goods. It's more useful than standing around and talking. Anyway, I'm gonna head over and get my goods. Now? But it's already nighttime. You can certainly send you off without any of my goods, can you? See ya. That was a nice little interaction. Surprised he didn't set up shop. But then again, there's already a shop right here, so would be kind of redundant. Ooh, gladiator shoes. I'm gonna buy them. I know I shouldn't, but... Oh, that was like a side quest thing that I accepted. Alright, I checked every place that we have already explored, and I have yet to see any new events since the cat thing with Luis. At least I'm pretty sure that was the last one. So I guess this is going to be it for today's episode. I have no idea how long this episode is going to be, because I'm going to be chopping it up like crazy. Alright, so, I am Rubescent the Collector Dragon, and I hope to see you all in the next episode. Please like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff. See you next time! Bye-bye!